Welcome to Crypto Highlights, where we summarize latest prominent news in crypto world. I am Emily Hunt. MicroStrategy CEO Michael Saylor has announced the company will continue to purchase hundreds of million dollars on Bitcoin and his outlook for crypto regulation in the U.S. Listen to this.
I tell people we will be buying Bitcoin at the top forever. When I found a really good idea and I underinvested in it, like Google was a good idea, Facebook was a good idea, Apple was a good idea, Amazon was a good idea, a digital monopoly that changes the world for a billion people is a good idea, and yet the most common two mistakes after finding a good idea is, first mistake is someone says something, they talk crap about your idea, there's FUD, oh, Australia's gonna tax Google, or somebody's gonna Amazon's gonna get regulated, or something will happen, and so people panic sell. And so whenever there's anxiety in the market and you panic sell, and then you never buy back in, you regret that. And the second thing you always regret is you wish you bought more. And so a lot of people in the world, I mean, they're basically being knocked around and traumatized because the media is incentivized to generate a new story every day, and if it bleeds, it leads. And nobody wants to read a story that the risk profile hasn't statistically changed versus last year, and there's no reason to read beyond this sentence. So normally they always write inflammatory, anxiety-inducing stories, and when people read them and they think about it, it gets them on the skin, then they panic and they do something irrational. My house in Miami Beach is 305 times as expensive as it was in 1930 when it was first sold. I have the bill of sale on my wall. If you back calculate, you conclude that the actual inflation rate of the money supply against scarce desirable assets is 7% a year for 100 years. The government statistic is less than 2%. And so you just have to ask yourself the question, do I want to sell something going up in value 7% a year when I could borrow money at 3% a year? And of course, the Bitcoin is more extreme. I mean, Bitcoin is appreciating not because of the rate of currency expansion, but also because of the rate of general mainstream investor adoption, and also because of the increase in technical utility due to the things like Lightning and the beautiful things that are being done by Cash App and the like. So, you know, we set up a credit line. We borrow against it. We do it responsibly. We had $5 billion in collateral. We borrowed $200 million. So I'm not telling people to go out and take a highly leveraged loan. What I am doing, I think, is doing my best to lead the way and to normalize the Bitcoin-backed financing industry. And I think the corporate beneficiaries will be the Bitcoin miners. Now, I tell people we will be buying Bitcoin at the top forever. I'm not trying to time the market. I don't intend to stop. You could think of MicroStrategy as we're kind of like your non-existent spot ETF.
Yeah.
If there was a spot ETF, you'd be paying 1% fee, and it would be not leveraged. With MicroStrategy, we have a software company that generates cash flow, and so we convert our cash flows into Bitcoin, and so we don't charge you a fee, we give you a yield. And between the cash flows from the software company and just a little bit of leverage that we can take via things like the Silvergate loan, we can give you a spot ETF that generates a 4 or 5% tax-deferred yield. And that's kind of an exciting thing. And when will we stop? Well, why would we ever stop? Well, we'll just keep accreting. It should get exponentially more expensive to buy the Bitcoin, but that's okay. You know, when Bitcoin's 500,000 a coin, someone's gonna say, well, why are you buying that? You bought some at 10,000. And the answer is gonna be, because it's more scarce, desirable property than anything else that I could buy. And When will you sell it? You're not going to sell it until you've got something better to buy, but there isn't anything that I could see in this universe better to buy. I don't think it could have been better than that. Never in 100 years did the executive branch ever endorse an asset class. When commodity index came out, the executive branch didn't say, figure out the commodities index. When John Bogle evangelized the Vanguard 500, the president didn't say every American and every agency should study the Vanguard 500 and indexing of equities, right? The last time the executive branch had something to say about asset class was the gold edict back in 1933, right? So I feel like we've got really good support from the administration. I think the regulators are progressive and very erudite. You know, when Jerome Powell, Janet Yellen, Gary Gensler have been asked about this, they say, look, it's a store of value asset. It's speculative. If people want to speculate, they can. It's not a currency. I think that all the regulatory agencies have some legitimate responsibility to work through. Here's the big idea, McKinsey, which is for a year, I've been in rooms with trillions and trillions of dollars, you know, and this is, it's like the Ray Dalio comment, the Jamie Dimon comment, it's something like this. It seems engineered perfectly. It's obviously better than gold. It's obviously better than all the other ideas we have. It's too perfect. It's too good to be true. And so I think someone's going to ban it. And that's not uncommon. People with large sums of money that are buying fixed income or buying equity index are like, yeah, it sounds really good on paper, but you know, it must be too good to be true. Nobody's gonna let that around. And so how do you answer that criticism when someone says it's too good to be true? And it is too good to be true. It's like perfect money. It's a perfect gold with none of the defects of gold. And it's a big tech monopoly with none of the exposure that Google, Facebook, Apple, and Amazon have, because they have people and they do things. And so I wanted something better than a big tech monopoly, and I want something better than gold, and so I have Bitcoin. It's too good to be true. Someone's going to ban it. And the single best way to refute that is say, well, this is what the President of the United States has said. Whereas 40 million Americans want this, I direct you to figure out how to bring it in the public policy framework. It's not going to be banned.